Hello friends, welcome back to Dungeon Hack. One moment, I just have to wait for my elevator to arrive. Here we go. Level 10, men's socks and undergarments. I'm Duke of the Bump. I am a cleric that is permanently invisible to undead, thanks to a strange glitch. I have a negative 5 armor class, which is quite good. If this was following D&D encumbrance rules, I would probably be unable to move because I'm wearing plate mail and I'm carrying just a ton of stuff. One Tlincali? Boy, that's a syllable the English language is really not prepared to deal with. The TL sound. Tlincali. Wow, that's hard to say. I'm just going to call it a scorpion monster because that's what it looks like. Scorpion monsters appeared in the board game Dragon Strike, which is a really fun kind of wet your feet D&D game. Kind of baby's first Dungeons & Dragons. Nah, that sounds dismissive. It's probably fun still today. It came with the best VHS tape ever to explain how to play. Which was, I mean, it was helpful. It was, you know, D&D was still pretty intimidating to a kid. And, you know, I mean, it was a board game aimed at families. But, you know, it was to get the kids involved in Dungeons and Dragons. And it came with just the best VHS tape ever. It was like 30 minutes long. It was in this weird pseudo Ralph Bashke rotoscoped kind of animation style. But not really. Like, I'm not really sure. It was processed. It wasn't like they animated, like they painted over the video frames with animation. But I mean, it was super corny, of course. It began with the face of a man just telling you to get ready for adventure in the most dire, serious way possible. It's a lot of fun. You should look it up. Just look up Dragon Strike tape on YouTube and you'll probably find it. But that was Annette, of course. Wasn't it? Oh, that was two Ettins, apparently. And wow, why does it say 7 of those have died? I haven't killed that many. I have a theory as to why it's getting the number of enemies wrong occasionally. I think there are like traps on the level somewhere that are killing more of the enemies than I'm killing, or adding to the total number of deaths for the enemies. That's the only explanation I can think of as to why the number of don't let the Ettin hit you. That's not a wise idea. That just did a ton of damage to me. Okay. I still have heal. Next time I take a beating like that, though, I'm gonna have to rest, get some of my higher level spells back. Oh god. There's a billion of them in there. And they have two heads, so it's actually 2 billion of them. In the Dragonstrike VHS tape, the Tlincali, the scorpion monster, was killed by, a player getting the bright idea to stab it with its own tail, which I get why they did that. It was to show people new to the game or new to that kind of game, hey, you don't have to just roll the dice and, you know, follow the rules. You can come up with new ideas and, you know, use your ingenuity to kind of solve problems in a way that you can't in most board games. Of course, I don't think stabbing it with its own tail would actually work if you were going by the rule book, because, oh no, wow, how did the Ettin get on that side of me? It must have walked through the teleporter just a moment before I did. Okay, so how am I going to deal with this little problem? I have a wand of distance. Oh, I have a wand of acid. I also have a cedar wand that I haven't identified yet. But if I take just a couple more hits from that Ettin, I'm toast. So I should probably teleport it away. I do still have that wand, right? Yeah, here we go. I'll just teleport it away and rest up and get some healing spells back. There we go. Oh, hey, it dropped its protection from poison scroll. That's nice. I have a feeling the scorpion monsters have some sort of poison-based attack. Call it a hunch. Okay, do I want to change my spells up at all? Probably not. I do want to take a protection from evil. Again, I'm not sure if any of these enemies qualify as evil. But just in case. I should get slow poison, I guess. Just in case. Those things do have some sort of poison attack. Well, I don't really need three aids, do I? I guess it doesn't matter. None of these other spells are useful to me at the moment. I could try messing around with whole person, I guess, but I don't know. It just seems like it would be more trouble than it's worth. Because this game is all about managing multiple monsters, and using whole person is just, you know, you don't want to focus too much on one monster. Wow, I have 70 of these. That's pretty good. I still can't tell if Magical Vestment is doing me that much good, but I guess I'll take it. Just in case it's providing me some protection that I'm not aware of. And I'll get another Cray food and water, I guess. I should take a neutralized poison. Again, just in case. Free action doesn't look like I'll need that on this level yet. I kind of want to take a true seeing spell, because it, not only does it let you see invisible walls and see in dark areas, it also identifies any cursed items that you find, which is nice. Kind of like detect magic, but with a red glow for cursed items instead of a blue glow for magic items. Flamestrike didn't seem to be doing me that much good. I could try Slay Living, but these monsters don't seem that tough. And I do want to try Sol Searing Orb against. I'm curious as to whether it acts like the Spiritual Hammer and returns to you every time you use it or not. Because if it does, then that might be a pretty decent replacement for Spiritual Hammer. Not that I'm having that much trouble so far. You know, knock on wood. Etc. Alright. Let's see how this works. Sol Searing Orb. Is it just like a one-shot deal, or does it... it looks like it was a one-shot deal. Does not appear... Oh, wait. Oh, that's an Ion Stone. Never mind. I thought that was the orb. Take that! Okay, well. Looks like, looks like Sol Searing Orb is an interesting it's an interesting one to play with, but not, it won't be my trusty standby like Spiritual Hammer is. Next time I run into a boss monster, I might try throwing a Searing Orb at him. Alright, well, I don't know what this Ion Stone does, but I do have room for another one. Let's go ahead and cast that True Seeing. Make sure it's not cursed. Okay, so it also detects just plain old magical items. Ooh. Well, this gold ring is cursed. I'm glad I cast that before I tried it on. What rings am I using now? Feather Falling and Regeneration. I think that's what I'll stick with. Oh, I still have plenty of food, too. That's nice. Alright, so I guess I might as well just ditch that, since... As far as I know, there's no way to completely cancel a curse on an item. Oh, yeah. Need to do all my buffs. Oops. Yeah, Cure Light Wounds, why not? I don't know if Slow Poison is... Okay, Slow Poison is something you use after you get poisoned. It doesn't, it's not like a buffer that protects you for if you get hit by poison. I guess Neutralized Poison will be the same way. Okay, that's good. Buffs don't really seem to be as important. Oh wait, I can go ahead and use that Ion Stone, even though I don't know what it does yet. It does something. That's good enough for me. So yeah, the Etten seems slow and manageable, as long as you can keep your distance. Kind of like the Ogre and the Flesh Golem and all that. Beware of an arrow shot from the bow of a great Medusa, for they are often poisoned. Didn't know Medusas were traditionally known for using bows and arrows. Wouldn't think they would need it. What with the petrifying gaze and all. But that does indicate that there are Medusas in this game, which I wasn't sure of. I think I remember Medusas from Eye of the Beholder, but obviously I never. Well, I guess I might have made it far enough in this game to see a Medusa, but I never really made it past level 10 because I never played anything other than easy. So I think Medusas would be like a higher level enemy. As is an illusionary wall straight ahead. Nice. That's my true seeing. Doing me some good there. So about my pronunciation of Kimura yesterday. I learned most of the words I know, or most of the words I learned as a kid were learned by reading books, not by hearing the word. So there are a lot of words I still don't know how to properly pronounce. So apologies to anyone who is put off by that. I did look up the word afterwards, and I believe it was pronounced. It's supposed to be pronounced Kimura. It would be helpful if I would actually remember that kind of thing. But I'll try to remember that for the future. Like, there are still words that I mispronounce because the first time I read them, you know, I had never heard the word before, and I kind of had to make up my own pronunciation. I'm about to get trapped. You better die quickly. I'm seeing double. Four Ettins. Like, for example, the word D-R-A-U-G-H-T is supposed to be pronounced draft, but I'll probably, like, when I read it, the pronunciation I hear in my head is always draught. It's probably always going to be that way. Because I didn't realize at the time that it was the UGH sound was like the UGH sound in laugh. That was weird. A strange tingling just went up my spine. Did that affect my stats? Doesn't look like it. I don't feel that weird tingling anymore. Interesting. So yes, Kimura. I think. So Blizzard announced some big news in the past couple days. Some exciting news. Probably the biggest announcement Blizzard's made in the past couple years. And anyone who is a longtime viewer of my streams, I'm sure, is super excited. But The Lost Vikings has been made available for free on Blizzard's website. It's a DOS version, which isn't the ideal version to play. But if you want a legal way to play The Lost Vikings without having to, you know, actually buy a Genesis or a Super Nintendo or whatever, then now's your chance. I guess you could have bought the DOS game, but not sure how easy that would be to find these days. Alright, so I don't have the Pearl yet. Unless it's this thing. No. How would it know, really? I mean, any small spherical object, I guess it would know because of magic. I really hope this tingling isn't something bad, because it's happening to me a lot. So yeah, Lost Vikings. Check it out. I don't think it has any multiplayer. Like, even local multiplayer. Which is a bummer, because you think the DOS version, or the PC version of a game, would be more likely to support multiplayer than the console version. Or at least be able to support three-player mode. I mean, it doesn't even have two-player mode. Which is really weird. I mean, one person could use the keyboard and one person could use a controller. Or, you know, you could daisy chain controllers together. Like, I had a Microsoft Sidewinder around that time period that had another controller port in it. And you could just daisy chain three of those suckers together and be on your way. So yeah, not sure why the DOS version doesn't have that. It's really unfortunate. As far as I know, the Genesis version of The Lost Vikings is the only Lost Vikings game on any platform to support three players. Which is baffling, because, I mean, that game was designed for three players. I mean, not really, it was designed for one player, but, I mean, it's a natural fit, you know? And no version of Lost Vikings 2... Uh-oh, I'm poisoned. That's not good. No version of Lost Vikings 2 has three players, which is really a tragedy. Alright, Yeah, here we go. Neutralized poison. I no longer feel the effects of poison. Nice. It was nice of the game to wait until I had that spell to start throwing poison monsters at me. Excuse me. I have a little bit of the hiccups here. I will take a sip of water to attempt to neutralize... I'll cast neutralize hiccups on myself. Or drink a potion of neutralize hiccups. Refreshing. So yeah, I think a couple other old Blizzard games are also available for free, like Rock and Roll Racing, which I never played, and Blackthorn, I think it was called, which I don't even know what that game is. Rock and Roll Racing is basically just a dumb ripoff of RC Pro-Am. The gimmick is that it has actual licensed music by, like, I think it has some Black Sabbath music in there and probably some Guns N' Roses or something. You know, that's interesting. I wonder if making that game available caused them to have to pay to license those tracks again, or to renew the license on them or whatever. Or I wonder if they just replaced all the music with generic music. Wait. Oh, never mind. I thought I saw a niche. Which, if they did replace the music, then I don't see why anyone will play that game, because the only reason to play it is because of the music gimmick. Otherwise, what are you doing? Just play RC Pro-Am. Alright, that's that clam door I still can't go in. So, need to go through this teleporter. That'll take me back over to this general area. And then Blackthorn, I think that's like some sort of side-scrolling action adventure game of some sort? I have no idea. Okay, this is where I want to... Hey! Boy, the way mobs interact with the teleporter can be really weird sometimes. There's no telefragging in this game, so if you teleport on top of a monster, it just kind of pushes it out of the way sometimes, but sometimes it's like you teleport on top of it. Jesus. Watch out for the Etten. Come on, Hammer. Thank you. I'm going to have to download Rock and Roll Racing and see how they actually handle that. Because with Lost Vikings, they did make some alterations to the game itself. Like, I think at the time, the logo would have still been Silicon and Synapse. I'm not sure about the DOS version, but the Genesis version, it was definitely Silicon and Synapse. And in the version they just released, they replaced the logo with a nice low-resolution Blizzard logo, which is kind of cool. And they replaced the copyright date to be like 1993 through 2014 or something. So I don't know, they might have gone in there and... But then what would they have replaced the music with? That's a good question. Or maybe because it's like cover versions. I mean, that's kind of generous. It's like digitized chiptune versions. I'm poisoned and I don't have another neutralized poison spell. I have slow poison, but I don't think that'll let me rest. I might be in trouble. poison is a new mechanic to me in this game. Suffers the ravages of poison. Where did it go? Oh, there it is. Oh, Jesus! Alright, let's, oops, wrong thing. Let's heal myself up a little bit here. Be on the lookout for scorpion monsters. Or Tlincali. Wait, try pronouncing a word with a TL sound. Alright, let's see what slow poison does for me. Alright, so that probably slows the damage I take. So what happens if I try to rest? I'm poisoned and might die in my sleep. Are you certain I should rest? I don't know if poison will just wear off or not. Do I have a scroll of neutralized poison? I might. Protection from poison, that would have been a useful one to cast. You know, Hero's Feast might cure poison, I'm not sure. Or actually, Heal might cure poison, now that I think of it. Let's try it. No longer feels the effects of poison. Okay, great. Let's rest and get neutralized poison back, because I do not want to be stuck with poison and no way to get rid of it. But with neutralized poison and heal, that gives me two good options. Let's see, cast True Seeing again, I guess. Why not? Go ahead and create food and water, since I had two of them. Did I remember to cast Magical Vestment last time? I don't remember. There are like three spells I have that use that red border now, so I get confused. So, Etrian Odyssey 4 is still going pretty well. All of my characters are level 10, which is still very early on in the game. The level cap appears to be somewhere around 40, but of course there's post-game content too. One commenter pointed out that the Etrian Odyssey series is known for brutal post-game content, but I'm not sure if I'll actually do any of that. I don't know, it depends on usually by the end of an RPG I'm pretty much done with it. Still have the hiccups, especially like a long RPG, and I'm not usually in the mood to play more of that game, especially if it's like brutally hard after that point. So if I feel satisfied after the actual game, I'll probably set Etrian Odyssey 4 down. But having a lot of fun with it so far. Very strategic combat. The exploration aspect is really fun. I don't know, there's something about actually drawing out your own map with an actual pen, or, you know, a virtual pen, a light pen, but there's something about it that just makes exploration that much more satisfying. It's like, yeah, the map isn't filling in as I walk around. Hey, there's a secret passage on my left. On my left. On my left. On my left? Okay. That's weird. Did say on my left, right? I'm not seeing a secret passage anywhere. Oh, wait. I'm not even looking at the actual walls. Is there, like, a button somewhere? Well, let's take out this walking hunk of pain. This 20,000-pound... heap of a man. Alright, so where did I get that message? It was like right here, right? Hey, I am exploring, thank you very much. Ow. No, 11 points of damage, that's not that bad. I don't have my shield equipped though. I probably should equip it. The thing about armor class in this game is that there's not really a way to reduce damage against yourself. Or there aren't very many ways. All armor class really does is make you harder to hit. So, you know, I can give the Etin a much smaller chance of hitting me, but still quite possible that it can take out like a third of my hit points in one attack, if the attack connects. This is still more Etrian Odyssey 4 music, by the way. Still don't have it out of my system quite yet. Wait, I saw a button on a wall somewhere around here. See, it said the secret passage was on my left, but it's clearly on my right. I must have been facing south at the time. Oh, I see. Very tricky. So even though I knew there was a secret passage there, I had to use my explorer's intuition to figure out how to actually get it. I know these aren't cursed because I have a true seeing in effect, so let's try them out. Same armor class. Thanks, game, but I'm good. So I'm not sure if we're at the point where the enemies are all about the same difficulty level. Kosh just said it was around level 8, but he wasn't 100% sure. Oh, I still need to go down that passage. I have to say the enemies don't seem to be ramming up in difficulty that much. The worst thing I've run into is probably the troll, and that was just because of how much. Well, I'd say this one is about on par with the troll as far as damage goes, but the Ettins don't seem nearly as hard to kill. So yeah, the troll probably still the most, if not the hardest monster, the most frustrating monster I've had to deal with. And the scorpion monster poisons you, which is a bummer, but as long as you have at least one thing that can neutralize poison at the ready, then you should be safe. Oh, I'm missing something because I still don't have the pearl that opens that door. Which means there must be a secret passage somewhere. Or I'm missing a niche on the wall, like I thought it was the last time. I didn't pick up a pearl, right? No, I did not. Okay, well, hopefully true seeing will make it a little bit easier to figure out where the actual secret passage is. Just making sure I can't bash down either of those barriers. I doubt it, since they look the same as all the other barriers I found, but figure it was worth a try. Hey! You guys still? Have you just been standing there waiting for me? Wait. Oh, I see. So, it was just a matter of killing the monsters. Once again, you think I would have learned my lesson and say, hey, I bet I just have to kill one of those monsters on the screen to get the last key I need. But no, my first instinct, once again, was to go looking for secret passages. Now I just have to remember which teleporter takes me there. I believe I need to go back through either this one or this one. I don't know. Let's try both. Alright, let's try the other one. I guess I could try this one. Shoot. See, if this was Etrian Odyssey, I could have just made a note on my map. Oh, hey, this is a whole new area here. That's cool. But yeah, I could have just jotted a little note on my map that said this teleporter leads to the door that you still need to unlock. All right. What about this one right by the entrance? That might, actually haven't gone through that one either. Hey, Etten. What's wrong? Are you afraid of me? I'm just a level 13 cleric. I'm nothing to be afraid of. And you're a giant hulking two-headed beast. Stop running away, you jerk. All I want to do is beat you to death with a magical hammer. I mean, I don't think it's that unreasonable a request. I mean, you have two clubs. How am I supposed to compete with that? Uh, Yeah, might as well use one of my multitude of silver coins here. Alright, nothing else of interest here. I don't know. It does like to fill in the whole map, so my instinct is to think there's a secret that leads here. But that doesn't look like the case. My true seeing definitely hasn't discovered anything, so. Okay. I don't remember which of these teleporters I've actually tried. I guess I could print out the map and jot a little note on it that way. I doubt the print function works. You know, let's try it. See what happens. Nothing. I think if you click save to disk, it actually makes a text file with like a crude ASCII representation of the current map. So I could go in and print that out if that actually worked. Of course, it's too late to start jotting notes now. I mean, I'm pretty much done. Only half an hour in. All I have to do is... open that last door. The clam door, as I like to call it. Or was it an oyster door? I don't know, it might have been a mussel door. So yeah, guys, Lost Vikings. That's a hell of a game. That's still one of my favorite games. I'd say top 10, definitely. It'd be, man, I don't know. That would be a tough list to make, my top 10 games of all time. I'm not gonna even try going into that here. But yeah, Lost Vikings would definitely be up there. Of course, if I had to recommend any version of it, I'd say play the Genesis version. Get two good friends together. Yell at each other for not being able to make simple jumps. Or actually just yell at Eric because he's the only one who can jump. Here we go. I knew I'd find it if I kept repeatedly walking into teleporters without paying attention. Oh yeah, this is the Tingle Hall. Also known as... the Tingle Hall is also the name of the location where you find Tingle in The Legend of Zelda. That was a bad joke. I need to workshop that one. I was in the right area. Like, making a Tingle reference is pretty funny. Because Tingle is a pretty funny character, but I need to work on my segues. Speaking of Tingle, what's the deal with Head and Shoulders? Does the Tingle mean it's working, or does it mean I'm gonna die? LOL. Hey, thanks everyone. Make sure you tip your waitress. Or waiter. Oh, that would be the boss creature. Let's get my Searing Orb ready, because I really want to kick some ass with that thing. If I can find my holy symbol. Wow, that thing's fast. Wait, is that just another one of those... Oh, right. I forgot to... I had to have a free hand. Is that one of those things I fought before? Ghost or whatever? What was that thing called? Watch Ghost? Is that just another Watch Ghost? It kind of looks like it. But it wouldn't throw another one of those at me, would it? I don't know. The Ion Stone absorbed the energy in the spell. Oh, nice! That's awesome. Wait, did it? Oh, I guess I killed it. So what was that thing? It was just a watch ghost, because this was 42 before, and now it's 43. That's weird. I guess that means I've crossed that threshold where the enemies are... where the enemies that throws at me are all roughly of the same difficulty level. Alright, so what is my armor class with the shield is still minus 5, right? Oh wait, I never read this journal page. Invulnerable to all but magical weapons. Boy, that makes them pretty unique in this game, let me tell you. Alright, so my base armor class with everything is minus 5. Okay. So, not as good as my plate mail, not as good as my plate mail. And, I guess that's it. Well, if it is just going to start throwing watch ghosts and stuff like that at me, then I guess I have my work cut out for me. Oh, hey! Wait, level 15? Wasn't I level 14 when I or level 13 when I started this? Pretty sure I was. Huh. Well, do I have the level 7 spells yet? I do. One available. I can cast Firestorm, which I assume is pretty awesome, or I can cast Restoration, which will undo the effects of a level drain attack, if cast within 24 hours of being hit by the attack. I want to get Firestorm, and if I do run into enemies that drain levels again, then I'll get Restoration. Still have two of those. I'll get a... Oh, wow, I got... How did I go up two levels that quickly? I'm sure I was 13 when I started this, and I don't remember. Maybe there was a lot going on, and the message just scrolled by too quickly. But still, damn. Alright, I have two more available. Let's go with another Cure Critical and another True Seeing, I guess. I have two more of these? Wow. Alright, let's get another Neutralized Poison and... I guess another Cure Serious Wounds. Alright. I have all I'm going to get of 1, 2, and 3. Or at least at the moment. Wow, I'm amazed I'm already level 15. That's just bonkers. I mean, this is definitely the highest character level I've ever had in the game. Firestorm. So yeah, I might have crossed that threshold where the game's not going to be interesting anymore. In which case, I have a lot of work to do to get myself... to keep myself entertaining. Wait, didn't that thing drop a helmet too? Did I already determine that... Oh wait, there it is. Alright. No, I can't put a helmet in that slot either. Lame. Alright, so minus 5 with the shield. With this helmet, still minus 5. Do I want the gold one or the one with that little leather ponytail? I think I'll stick with the gold one. Get the hell out of here, helmet. I guess I can wait to do all my buffs because the exit has to be, like, right here, right? Yep, there it is. Alright, well, this has been a slightly shorter episode than normal. I did, new snake monster. Nice. Alright, well, tune in tomorrow for Let's Play Dungeon Hack level 11. We are officially farther than we would have gotten if I was just playing uneasy. And we have 7 more levels of potentially boring enemies to slog through. So, let's all brush our teeth and drink our milk and eat our vegetables and make sure you call your mom this Sunday. I mean, come on, she's... after everything she's done for you, the least you could do is just give her a call once a year. I know talking on the phone sucks, but... something you just have to do. Okay. Bye, everyone.